I'm very aware that people don't know a lot about me, and that's not on purpose. I'm not a person that goes to parties. I don't hang out a lot in Hollywood. I'm just not that guy. I'm in Georgia on the porch with the dogs. You know, that's happy for me. I'm sitting somewhere reading a book under a tree. I'm good with that. I don't need to be on the red carpet. I don't need to be in the limelight. So when people see me, yeah, they're usually like, wow, you're a pretty big guy. And apparently that did work for Alex Cross. Apparently I am James Patterson's explanation of his description of Alex Cross. So I guess it worked out well. The thought of playing any character in a James Patterson film is amazing because I love the characters that he writes. They're so rich. And to know that Morgan Freeman had done this role was very, very intimidating, but also very thrilling to know that I would be taking on something that he had said yes to, because he's very selective. So I just followed Morgan's lead on this because he's such a brilliant, brilliant actor. Ed's a really good guy, just a nice, even guy, no surprises, very talented, and there's our bond on screen is really cool. I mean, we are the new Starsky and Hutch, man. It's just really great. You know, if I were Irish Catholic, then Ed and I would be brothers. I mean, he's just, we fit, and I love the way, I'm telling you, his attitude about life is just so great, and he brings that into the film. It's just, it's all great. This is, you know, I'm doing what I love. We get to do what we love every day. And just, I cannot speak highly enough about him as a person, because he's just a really decent human being. And it's good to have that kind of energy around you, supporting you. I'm asking questions. You know, it's my first time doing a movie that wasn't my own other than Star Trek, but first time doing a lead. So I'm asking him questions. And again, he's very generous. He's very helping. It's been fantastic. I was doing Krav Maga three times a week, and I think that's the hard, because I was working out in the morning at like 6 a.m. and then at noon I was doing Krav Maga training for an hour, and that Krav Maga training is the most ass-kicking workout I've ever experienced in my life. But it was also very relaxing once it was all over. Just it feels good to beat the hell out of something for an hour and then, you know, just be exhausted from it. I'm playing a character called Alex Cross, written by James Patterson, made famous in all of his novels. Morgan Freeman played the character early on in a couple of movies. But Alex is a detective who is a psychologist and a profiler, and just a brilliant family man, loves his family dearly, loves his children dearly, but he's a very different at home and at work. When he's at work, he is this panther on the prowl. He's thinking, he's overthinking, he's analyzing, he's always inside of his head in the moment. It's one case that changes his entire life, that changes his entire family's life. And it's all about one person that he's profiling that becomes his biggest nemesis, who destroys and takes away a lot of things that he loves and sends him out on a path of hell-bent revenge to catch this guy and get even. It's interesting to have an opportunity to play a character that pushes it, that pushes the limits, that allows himself to go past where in normal life no person should. But sometimes, I love the line in the movie when you set out for revenge, dig two graves, because even though he survives this thing, I don't know if the man that he was survives. I met Matthew at the production office, and the first day, yeah, he walks up to me, he says, "I'm Matthew." I said, "I'm Tyler, and this will be our only time talking," pretty much. He said, "Yep, you're right," and we went in two different directions. That was a treat to have Miss Cicely Tyson in the film. I didn't ask for it. I didn't nudge it. When Rob called and said, "You know, what did you think about Miss Cicely Tyson playing this role?" And he goes, I said, yeah. To myself, I said, "Well, if that's what you think," but no, it was great. Intimidating. I think to be in a scene with her and Jean Renault those were like dream come true moments for me. Jean Renault is just the subtleties and the little things that he would do in the scene, just the slightest raise of an eyebrow or the slightest twitch in his eye, I was fascinated by it. And she was the same way. She's really spirited, really, really joyful. I mean, she brings joy to the room. She brings joy to the role. And it doesn't hurt to have a beautiful woman sitting next to you in the scene. I've been a big guy, and I've always been aware of my size and height. So I always try to make myself a little smaller because, you know, when you're 6 feet in the fourth grade, all the other kids are like, look at the giant. So you try to make yourself smaller. So in those scenes where Rob is saying, just go for it, you know, knock this guy on his ass and just go for it and dive, I'm thinking, I don't want to hurt anybody. But yeah, I just had to cut loose and let Alex be Alex and put Tyler aside for a minute. This movie takes you really on a roller coaster. I mean, it should be an edge of your seat thriller that you're enjoying 1 minute with the laughter and the love of the family, and then you're in a crazy battle the next minute. I love a movie that takes you on a journey like life. One day you're happy and smiling, the next day you're finding yourself in some tragic situation that you've got to make your way through.